Man living under certain economic conditions is no longer in possession of the fruits of his life. His life is not his. His life is lived according to conditions determined by somebody else. I would say that on this particular point, which is very important indeed in the early Marx, you have a basically Christian idea. Christianity is against alienation. Christianity revolts against an alienated life. And I believe that by openness to Buddhism, to Hinduism, and to these great Asian traditions, we stand a wonderful chance of learning more about the potentiality of our own traditions, because they have gone, from the natural point of view, so much deeper into this than we have.
I was knocked over with a rush of relief and thankfulness at the obvious clarity of the figures, the clarity and fluidity of shape and line, the design of the monumental bodies composed into the rock shape and landscape, figure, rock, and tree. Looking at these figures, I was suddenly, almost forcibly jerked clean out of the habitual half-tied vision of things, and an inner clearness, clarity, as if exploding from the rocks themselves, became evident and obvious. The rock, all matter, all life, is charged with Dharmakaya. Everything is emptiness, and everything is compassion. I don't know when in my life I have ever had such a sense of beauty and spiritual validity running together in one aesthetic illumination. I think sometimes that I may soon die, though I am not yet old. Walking toward the center without quite knowing where I was going, suddenly I came to a dead end, but on a height, looking at a great bay, an arm of the harbor.
We can no longer rely on being supported by structures which may be destroyed at any moment by a political power, a political force. You cannot rely on structure. According to the Marxist formula, in which communism consists in a society where each gives according to his capacity and each receives according to his needs. Now, if you will reflect for 2 seconds on that definition, you will find that's a definition of a monastic community. That is precisely what monastic community life has always attempted to do. And it is my personal opinion that monastic community life is really the only place in which this can be done. So I will conclude on that note. I believe the plan is to have all the questions for this morning's conferences this evening at the panel. So I will disappear from view and we can all have a Coke or something. Thank you very much.